class. Today we're going to be reading Honey, Honey, Lion by Jan Brett. Can anybody tell me what the author does in a story? Jess?
Writes the words.
What about an illustrator? Do you know what the illustrator does?
Draws the pictures.
You're right. Well, this is a very special book because Jan Brett is the author and the illustrator. So what does that mean, Jess?
She writes the words and draws the pictures.
She writes the words and draws the pictures. Correct. So, Jan Brett wrote this story and it's from Africa. Do you know any animals that live in Africa?
Polar bears.
That was a good guess, but polar bears live where it's super, super cold. Animals in Africa live where it's super, super hot. Can you help me point to the animals in all of these pictures? So a hippo lives in Africa. A lion lives in Africa. A giraffe. A zebra. And an elephant. Let's see what all these animals are up to. Honey, Honey, Lion, a story from Africa, written and illustrated by Jan Brett. In Africa, the honey guide and the honey badger are partners when it comes to honey. The little bird follows a bee to its hive, and then she leads the honey badger there to break it open with its big, strong claws. Together, they share the sweetness, and that is the way it has always been. Jess, can you point to the honey badger's big, strong claws?
Right there!
They are very big, aren't they?
Yes.
Maybe this day, Badger was hungrier than usual. Maybe he forgot about Honey God, who showed him the way. Or could he have been thinking, my strong claws do all the hard work. Whatever the reason, that day Badger would not share. Do you think sharing is good or bad?
I don't like sharing.
Why don't you like to share?
I just don't like sharing with my sister. I want it all to myself.
You want it all to yourself? I think that's what the Honey Badger wanted. But I don't know if the Honey Guide liked that. Honey Guide scolded Badger as he waddled back to the jackalberry tree, his tummy almost touching the ground. She fussed and fumed as he tried to fit into his burrow. Finally, she cried out for all the animals to hear, "No fair, no fair!" Soon, all the guinea hens were broadcasting the news. Honey Guide is in a major rage. Jess, do you remember why Honey Guide is in such a major rage? Why she's so upset?
Because Badger wouldn't share with her.
What wouldn't he share?
The honey?
The honey. But Badger didn't hear. He was sound asleep, smiling, snoring, and hiccuping from his big meal. Grumph! Badger roared out the loudest hiccup of all, and its deep, low rumble gave Honey Guide an idea. The next morning, Badger woke up super hungry, his tummy flat as a pancake. That's when Honey Guide flew by, heading for the great gray Bobab. "Honey, honey, honey," she cried, grinning. The little bird zigzagged over its large roots. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter. Badger ran after her. Pitter?
Patter!
Patter! Honey Guide flew low across the waterhole. Splish, splash. Badger paddled after her. Splish,
splash,
splash. Honey Guide glided to the top of a termite mound and bounced on one foot. Sprung! Badger scrambled to the top and bounced off. Sprung! Jess, look how high the honey badger's jumping.
Whoa.
Very high.
Super high.
Honey Guide landed on a hollow log. It echoed as she stomped along. Boom, boom. Jess, have you ever been somewhere where your voice echoed?
Yeah, when I'm outside playing and my mommy wants me to come home, her voice echoes.
Her voice echoes? Well, that's what happened in Africa because it's so wide and open. Badger hurried to catch up. Boom, boom. Next, Honey Guide flitted through a stand of papyrus. Tall, dry reeds waved back and forth. Clickety-click, clickety-click. Badger traipsed along, muttering, "Where is that honey?" The papyrus rattled as he went by. Clickety, click. Honey Guide led him through a field of golden bristle grass. Swish, swish. Badger huffed and puffed, but the thought of the delicious meal waiting for him kept him going. Swish, swish. Imagine how long that grass is.
Yeah, you can only see the zebra's heads.
And zebras are big animals, right? Mm-hmm. So that means that if you can only see their heads, the grass must be very, very tall.
Yep.
So do you think it's kind of hard for honey badger to get through all of the grass?
Yeah, look, his tongue's sticking out because he's so tired.
He looks really exhausted. By now, Badger was tired and wet, itchy and sore, but he didn't slow down because Honey Guy was just ahead of him. She flashed her wings, fanned her tail, and dove under an acai tree. Badger charged in after her, singing triumphantly, "Honey, honey, what do you think's going to be behind here?" Should we find out?
Yes.
Lion!
Whoa!
Everybody, let's all make the sound that a lion makes on the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
Roar!
Those were good, scary lion noises. Lion, lion!
Lion!
Lion! Badger turned on his tail and ran. Just, Honey Badger looks really scared right now, doesn't he?
Yeah, look at how scary the lion is.
So scary. He's probably mad.
Or hungry.
Or hungry for the honey badger. Swish, swish through the grass, clickety-click into the papyrus, boom, boom over the hollow log. Sprong over the termite mound, splish, splash across the waterhole, pitter-patter out of the babo roots. How do you think the honey badger feels right now?
Scared and tired.
Scared and tired because he had to run all the way back to where he came from. Badger dashed into his burrow. Honey Guy cheered. In a flash, Badger was as far from the entrance as he could be. Right behind him was Lion's huge paw, batting the air, but he could not reach him. And that is the closest any animal could be to an angry lion and live to tell the tale. That evening, Mongoose squeaked to Elephant, who trumpeted to Hippo, who bellowed to Warthog, who squealed to Bishop Bird, who piped to Hyena, who whooped to Zebra, who snorted to Giraffe, who was overheard by Guinea Hen, who bugled it far and wide. It was the Bush Telegraph, and it said, "If Honey Guy leads you to a beehive, be sure and reward her, or next time she will lead you to a lion." Now that the honey badger knows that it needs to share with the honey guide, do you think he's going to continue to share with him?
Yes.
Yeah, so what's going to happen next time, Jess, next time you and your sister don't get along and you don't want to share with her?
Something bad's going to happen, and she'll get mad at me.
Mm-hmm, so you need to share because sharing is caring, right?
Yes.
All right, honey, honey, lion.